Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common Hyundai 2.0 turbo engine problems. So the Hyundai Theta engine family has been around since 2004 and still remains in production through this day. So specifically in this video talking about common problems, we are looking at the 2.0 Theta 2, the 2-liter turbocharged engine. There are a couple different variants of the 2.0 liter turbocharged Theta 2 engine. So one variant is the MPI, which stands for multi-point or multi-port injection. And so this engine uses standard port fuel injection and is only in the Hyundai Genesis Coupe. And then the next main variant of the 2.0 Turbo Theta 2 engine is the GDI version, which stands for gasoline direct injection. Unlike traditional port injection, these direct injection engines actually spray fuel directly into the cylinders. With the GDI, the gasoline direct injection engine, there are two variants of that engine. They're pretty closely related, but one of the variants is just specifically designed for rear-wheel drive models like the G70, G80, and the Kia Stinger. And so this engine has a slightly different compression ratio at 10.0 to 1. Anyway, jumping right into some of the most common problems for the Hyundai 2.0T Theta 2 engine. At number one, we have carbon buildup. This is the one that relates to why we differentiated between the MPI and GDI versions of the Hyundai 2.0T. This issue only affects the GDI. So the Hyundai Genesis Coupe with the multi-point fuel injection isn't prone to the carbon buildup issues. However, on the gasoline direct injected engines, there is no fuel spraying over the intake ports and intake valves, so all engines produce some degree of oil blow-by, which makes its way into the intake tract, where it can then stick to the back of intake valves as well as the walls or the ports for the intake valves. Essentially, what happens is as that oil blow-by gets in there and sticks, eventually it hardens and forms what's known as carbon deposits or carbon buildup. And again, this is mostly just because it doesn't have standard port injection. Normally you would have fuel flowing through those ports, which would wipe off any oil deposits and effectively eliminate carbon buildup. However, with direct injection, there is no fuel spraying over that, and so that leads to that buildup of carbon on the intake valves and ports. Ultimately, it's not a huge issue in the grand scheme, but it's something to be on the lookout for, especially with any 2.0T engines that are nearing or surpassing 100,000 miles. We'll probably have a little bit of carbon buildup. Now, a lot of these engines probably will go their entire lives without having this issue addressed. It's not something that's going to cause any longevity or real reliability concerns. However, as the carbon does build up and become more severe, it can start limiting and restricting airflow into the cylinders, which can result in primarily power loss, which is hard to tell because this is something that occurs over years and years and tens of thousands of miles. So you likely won't notice the power loss. It's not something that happens overnight or happens rapidly. However, you might start running into other drivability issues, rough idle, stuttering, or hesitation while accelerating, and a couple other issues along those lines. So really, if you're looking for maximum performance and just looking to keep the Hyundai 2.0T running as well as possible, then it's a good idea to go ahead and have those intake valves cleaned roughly around the 100,000 mile ballpark. The easiest method to do that is simply walnut blasting. Moving on to common problem number two for the Hyundai 2.0 Turbo Theta 2 engine, we have oil leaks. There are a couple different things here to discuss with the oil leaks. Number one, there's the oil feed line, and this was actually recalled, and the updated part is an effective solution. So this mostly just affects some older 2.0T engines with that oil feed line leaking. Doesn't seem to be a huge number of issues with this part once it's updated with the newest version. A relatively minor issue in the grand scheme. Moving on to number two for oil leaks, we have the valve cover gasket. The valve cover gaskets are a very simple issue and simple solution. It's not just the Hyundai 2.0T. Tons and tons of cars are subject to oil leaks from the valve cover gaskets, especially as they get older and surpass that roughly 8-year and 100,000 mile ballpark. The valve cover gasket is just subject to a lot of heat in general, and over time that rubber gasket tends to wear down, becomes brittle, starts cracking, and then you get an oil leak from the valve cover area and specifically that valve cover gasket. Relatively minor thing, not a design flaw or really a huge issue, just something that a lot of different cars and engines, including the Hyundai 2.0T, are subject to when they get a little bit older and higher mileage. And again, with the Theta engine family being a little bit older, some of these engines are past that 10-year mark and well past 100,000 miles. And so a couple oil leaks, especially an oil leak from the valve cover gasket, is certainly fair game at that kind of age and mileage. Moving on to issue number 3 with the Hyundai Theta 2.0 turbo engine, we have engine failure. So fairly significant and serious issue here. This is something that there are a lot of lawsuits and a lot of information floating around in regards to engine failures on the Hyundai 2.0 Theta 2 engine. And so the engine failures mostly affect the Santa Fe, the Sonata, as well as the Kia Optima, Sorento, and Sportage. So those models seem to be mostly affected by these engine failures. And it is primarily 2011 through 2014 models that run into these engine failures. Ultimately, what the engine failures seem to boil down to is just debris left over from the manufacturing process, which in turn restricts oil flow, and that tends to wear down the rod bearings quickly. Once those rod bearings seize, that's a serious issue and typically results in complete engine failure and total loss of the engine. Very serious issue with these engine failures on the 2011 to 2014 models with the Theta 2 turbocharged engine. Kia and Hyundai did issue some recalls, and of course they offer a good warranty as well for these vehicles, so that at least resolves some of the engine failure problems. If you run into that, try to work with Hyundai or Kia and see if they will help you out, foot the repair bill, or at least give you some assistance in these issues, just since it was something that was so common. Serious issue, again, lots of information available for engine failures on the Hyundai 2.0T engine. Something to certainly be on the lookout for if you are in the market for a 2011 to 2014 model, even if Hyundai or Kia does cover the repair or it's still under warranty. Still quite a pain because that's a lot of downtime for the vehicle being in the shop for a total engine replacement. Certainly not something that happens overnight and usually not even in a week or two. So certainly can be a frustrating issue to run into even if it ends up being free and no expense to you. Moving on to issue number 4 for the Hyundai 2.0T engine is excess oil consumption. Really what excess oil consumption means is if the engine is consuming or losing more than roughly 1 quart of oil every 1,000 miles, that is typically considered excess oil consumption. Now, this problem can sometimes tie into the engine failures. Of course, as an engine is nearing that point of failure, it will tend to consume a lot more oil. And so this could tie into those engine failures, so certainly something to consider if you're looking for one of those 2011 to 2014 models, or you own one and you have excess oil consumption. It could be something that ties into the engine failure and the rod bearings being worn down from the debris during manufacturing. Occasionally, this excess oil consumption can be normal, quote unquote, especially if you have some sort of oil leak or some sort of other issue on hand. Ultimately, usually if it's not tied to the engine failure or you can't find any specific issue, it's not a huge problem and shouldn't cause any major concerns. Just make sure you're checking your oil levels and that you have adequate oil in the engine at all times. So maybe carry an extra liter or a couple extra liters with you in the vehicle just in case it does get low. Because of course, running the engine lower on oil for extended periods of time can cause excess wear and tear and potential engine problems or failure. That wraps up the 4 most common problems for the Hyundai 2.0T. Overall, we will give this engine roughly average remarks for reliability. It doesn't really have any serious flaws or issues. Again, we discussed that oil feed line, the leaking from that, and that was addressed via a recall. Carbon buildup, that's just kind of the nature of owning a gasoline direct injection engine. And then otherwise, the excess oil consumption and engine failure are really the two main things that bring down the Hyundai 2.0T. But fortunately, at least with those engine failures, Hyundai and Kia have great warranties from the factory. And given the recalls and lawsuits and all of the stuff floating around about those engine failure problems, In most cases, these engines are repaired for no cost to the end consumer. Hopefully at this point, most of those engines that were faulty and had issues have already been replaced, but certainly something that brings down that reliability of the Hyundai 2.0T in general. Outside of those issues, it's really a pretty solid engine and doesn't have any significant concerns or design flaws. That said, that wraps up our video for today. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the Hyundai 2.0T. Thanks, guys.